The Philippine Federation of the Deaf rejects the apology of Communications Assistant Secretary Mocha Uson and blogger Drew Olivar for making fun of the deaf in a video. The two are accused of violating the Magna Carta for Disabled Persons. The group files a complaint against Uson and Olivar before the Office of the Ombudsman. The group also cites the Code of Conduct and Ethical Standards for Public Officials and Employees and the Anti-Cybercrime Law in its complaint. Uson posted a video on Facebook of Olivar mimicking sign language and making sounds as imitating the deaf. She could be heard laughing in the background. Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque says Malacañang will not raise any objections if the ombudsman decides to dismiss Uson.
Let's wait for the decision of the ombudsman dahil meron na namang ganyang complaint. The ombudsman can already order the dismissal of anyone in government because it is both an administrative and a criminal case. Igagalang po ng palasyo ang proseso. Kung sinabi ng ombudsman si Baken, hindi po natin tututulan yan.
6 people are killed and dozens are missing after a landslide unleashed by monsoon rains strike Naga City, Cebu. Days of heavy monsoon rains caused a steep slope of limestone to collapse into homes early Thursday, September 20. The tragedy comes days after Typhoon Ompong, international name Mangkhut, battered the north with heavy winds and rain. Naga City Police Chief Inspector Roderick Gonzalez says more or less 24 houses are affected in barangays Tinaan and Naalan. Civil Defense spokesman Julius Regner says 64 are missing and 6 are confirmed dead. Search and rescue in the area began early Thursday. The government plans to give out access cards for Boracay visitors. The Environment Department or DENR on Wednesday says cards would help monitor and control the number of visitors on the island. A study commissioned by the DENR says the island can take in only up to 55,000. Of that number, 19,215 are tourists. Tourists would have to register under a system that takes note of how many days they intend to stay in Boracay. Boracay and Aklan residents would be issued access cards as well. The system would be implemented during the dry run on October 15. Boracay will be reopened to the public on October 26. Senator Coco Pimentel will tie the knot with Ana Catrina Yu in less than a month. The wedding includes big names in politics. President Rodrigo Duterte will grace the October 18 wedding at the Coconut Palace. The wedding will take place after the filing of certificates of candidacy for the 2019 elections. Duterte and Special Assistant to the President Bongo are listed among the couple's principal sponsors. Also included are former House Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez, Senate President Tito Soto, and wife Helen Gamboa. Soto replaced Pimentel as Senate President in May 2018. Avatar: The Last Airbender is coming back as a live-action series on Netflix. The show's original creators, Michael DiMartino and Brian Konietzko, will serve as showrunners and executive producers in partnership with Nickelodeon. The series follows main protagonist Aang and his friends as they lead epic, action-packed adventures on their quest to save the world from Fire Lord Ozai and the Fire Nation. The creators say, "We can't wait to realize Aang's world as cinematically as we always imagined it to be and with a culturally appropriate non-whitewash cast." A 2010 movie adaptation directed by M. Night Shyamalan cast white actors for characters of Asian descent.